Bitcoin looks good for the immediate future, the bullish reversal is still in play, and we may be in for a pump towards the mid to late 40,000s, but that's when the real danger arises, one that could be devastating. People in general are overwhelmingly bearish on Bitcoin, and justifiably so, for there are a lot of technical dangers lurking about under the technical surface. Yet things always look the darkest at the bottom, just like buying the top appears the most obvious thing ever. The old saying goes to buy when there's blood in the streets, and with a Bitcoin fear and greed index reading at 13 out of 100 for extreme fear, it might just be bloody enough for that reversal. In the previous episode, we talked at length about how this right here was the likely bottom because of a bunch of bullish reversal signs. And despite the bearish tendencies, that theory is still in play and will remain so until proven otherwise. And by otherwise, we mean any break below the $30,000 support. In this episode, we'll go over the threats to the current technical levels. For bullish reversals or not, there are a lot of obstacles that need to be overcome before we can draw a sigh of relief. But more importantly, we'll discuss what would likely happen if or when Bitcoin were to break below the $30,000 support, as in target levels, and what will happen afterwards. For a pump potentially closing below it, two very important things will be triggered. Firstly, the bullish reversal pattern will be automatically disqualified. And secondly, as this significant area of support has been tested one too many times already, I don't expect it to sustain much more pressure. And given that Bitcoin moved rather exponentially from $20,000 to $30,000 back in December, there is no support level to speak of whatsoever. In this sense, if 30,000 were to break, then fasten your bloody seatbelts, for it'll be a ride we'll all likely feel in our stomachs. But breaking 30,000 doesn't need to happen right away. No, we might be in for a decent pump first, one into the mid to late 40,000s. And that in itself is the main theme of this episode. The very technicals that support such turn-off events. For this is much more likely than you might think. But before going any further, the mandatory stuff. Nothing of what I say is financial advice. And for more on this, please read the disclaimer at the beginning. And if this episode helps straighten out what's going on in Bitcoin land, then please return the favor by hitting the like and subscribe buttons. These episodes take a lot of time and effort to make. Without further ado, let's now look at those very important technicals. Sure, we got ourselves a bunch of technical reversals in favor of the bulls, and as mentioned, those all remain in play until proven otherwise. For we're not here to predict, we're here to identify key levels of relevance, and on the downside, that relevance spells $30,000. On the upside, however, there are two things in particular that can cause a further pump, but such pump in itself does by no account mean the coast is clear for new all-time highs. For we may in fact be in for something of a nasty treat. First of all, we have a bullish RSI divergence on the daily. The price is trending downwards, whereas the RSI is steadily inclining. But as anyone knows who's watched the RSI trilogy, these divergences are a bit more complex than that, for this doesn't automatically mean that prices will continue up. No, whenever there's a downtrend, the RSI tends to recover fast upon any correction. This can best be regarded as it is taking a deep breath and amassing new Iron Man power before proceeding lower. And that could very well be what we're looking at. However, in this case, I am personally biased towards a bullish move, solely because of the bullish reversals we got last week. So for as long as the $30,000 support holds up, it's got a bullish bias, period. The second part is where things get truly interesting. As you can see, we have a 6-month long RSI decline on the daily, perfectly visualized by this brick wall-like line at which the RSI is currently facing resistance for the 5th or 6th time, depending on whether you count this almost rejection or not. If Bitcoin were to break this diagonal resistance, I do expect there to be quite a bit of dammed up power to be released, thus causing a relief rally. And just how far that rally might take us, we'll look at in a bit. But as always within technical analysis, we need confirmation, for until that, the 30k support is cracking loudly beneath us like bursting ice. However, in the short term, we have a steadily ascending trend line on the 1 hour chart, one that has just taken out a new pivot top and that has broken above this resistance zone. This should statistically lead us straight towards the next resistance level, and a key one at that. But as that would equate to the diagonal RSI resistance being broken, I wouldn't expect that level to put up much of a fight. And especially so as it's already been tested 6 times in just 6 weeks. And as we know, the more times a support or resistance is tested, not only the weaker it gets, it also pents up energy for a stronger move. We have also just dodged the threat of a 4-hour chart closing on the upper bearish blue, a line that has caused some serious damage to the price in recent history. Moving on, people think Bitcoin looks weak, its sentiment is rock bottom low, and the majority expects further downside. Again, I'm not saying they're wrong, all I'm saying is that we're more likely to be in for a relief rally to regain the stupid money's trust before plunging deeper, thus causing maximum pain and despair to the market collective. And this would make perfect sense from a technical point of view as well, for look at this evil baby right here. We could be in for a major ABC correction, which in turn would support a B wave relief rally. And to the unknowing masses, such rally would regain the trust and confidence in the market, which would ultimately cause increasingly more damage upon a final C wave correction. For such C wave would take most people by surprise, and therein lies its treacherous beauty. Now, we've talked quite a bit about an ABC correction on this channel a few weeks back, but at the time from the point of a totally different technical prerequisite. In that case, as long as the $42,000 target that we initially had would have stood up, it would have amounted to a perfect ABC correction for the time being. One that would have been a perfect and healthy fourth wave correction for further bullish upside. And why then is that? Well, because the A wave and C wave are typically of identical length, either in factual numbers or in percentages. In this sense, as Bitcoin far preceded the $42,000 target, it in fact disqualified its validity. With that said, an ABC correction is still very much in play. It will just look different, and by different, I mean brutal. If we expand on the Elliott Wave Theory, we are likely in for a zigzag correction, which moves as a 5-3-5. In this sense, we may already have concluded the 5 moves of the A Wave. It could be, or we could be in for a further move down towards the 26 to 27k or so before initiating the B Wave. I really don't think that could be the case, but that the A Wave bottom at 28,600 has already been set. By this token, the next line in this procedure would be an ABC B wave, which we might have literally just initiated. This B wave should align with the $46,500 area, as it's where the diagonal resistance meets the 0.5 Fib. For one thing to keep in mind is that Fib levels are particularly strong and reliable when it comes to Elliott Wave Theory. In this sense, I'd expect a move towards the $39,000 to $41,000 resistance zone, give or take, for a B wave of the B wave correction, before taking off to the resistance cluster, at which Bitcoin would then initiate its 5-leg C wave down. And whether this Elliott theory proves to be valid and in play or not, the $46,500 area in particular will be one of high significance. I will seriously contemplate selling everything at that point and rather buy it back at $52,000 or above, as the risk to reward in this area is absolutely dreadful. And that includes the 618 Fib at 51,002, although it is technically a less likely B wave endpoint. But more on that a bit later. Sure, I'd been missing out on some value, 12.5% to be precise, but neither would I have to suffer through another gut-wrecking minus 55% downside. For we dodged the first one with proper technical analysis, and we sure as hell are not gonna stick around for the second one. We'll now get to the targets and why the $46,500 area holds a high likelihood of being the red flag danger zone. If we look at the weekly chart, we can draw a diagonal support line from the accumulation bottom in 2018. What we'll do is to draw a so-called internal support line as opposed to an external one. An internal support line basically means that we focus on the areas of the most price action reversals or touches, and hence ignore wicks and outlier behaviors and fakeouts, such as the Corona crash. An external line, on the other hand, focuses on price extremes and would be drawn like this. However, as it only have two touch points anyway, it will be invalid. You need three. Nonetheless, this internal line makes up for a reliable primary trend line, one with a healthy angle, just like we called for continuously in February and March on this channel. This primary trend line is in turn supported by a near identical secular trend line that stretches all the way back to the 2015 accumulation bottom. So careful what we wish for we might just get it. Now, if Bitcoin were to break down, it would be more than fair to assume that this line would make up for a rather magnetic force. In such case, we're talking prices in the low 20,000s and with a possible spike below it. And as long as we don't touch or break the previous local pivot top on the weekly chart, as in just south of 14,000, then our secular 5-wave bullish count is still in play, of which this correction is the 4th wave. The only technical conflict, in my opinion, is the fact that it's typically either the second or fourth wave that digs deep. For according to textbook Elliott Wave Theory, if the second correction is deep, then the fourth wave shouldn't be, and vice versa. In this case, the second correction stands at more than minus 70%. A breakdown towards the low 20,000s would amount to the same. This on its own would be the prime argument to refute our own ABC correction thesis. As I know for a fact that most of you viewers are way above average intelligence and possess a high level of technical understanding, I am equally certain that many of you may have a satisfying answer to this dilemma. If you do, please let me know in the comments section below. I would really value that. Now, the reason why the $46,500 resistance confluence that we talked about earlier is the one of importance is because it neatly matches the A wave correction. For the A wave corrected at a staggering 55% on its own. If we reverse engineer the C wave from the $20,000 target, we get the very same $46,500 area. This would not only complete the secular fourth wave, it would equally so kill off any last market optimism, which would pave the way for a speedy recovery. If, and strongly emphasizing the if here, if Bitcoin were to eventually break below the $30,000 support and proceed to complete the fourth wave, then expect the price to recover fast and aggressively. But until then, until Bitcoin fails to break above the $46,500 level, and until it breaks below $30,000, things do look good, and this whole Elliott Wave theory may eventually be discarded altogether. But until then, it is certainly something we need to keep an eye on, or else we could be in for a living nightmare. Therefore, skipping the double red alert danger zone between $46,000 and $52,000 is the way to go from a gaming theory perspective. Any closing above $52,000 on the other hand, and the coast should be clear. That was all for now. Thank you and goodbye.